Commander, urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command. We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology in live-fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
Are you telling me this computer is thinking on its own?
We're not stupid, Shepard. This is a virtual intelligence, not a true AI. It's not self-aware, and it can't access any external systems. We didn't do anything illegal here. Virtual intelligence support is critical to our military success. VIs process thousands of status reports and react in nanoseconds. No human can do that. We need you to fight your way through the training ground at the VI core and manually disable it.
Can't you disable it remotely?
Our fail-safes aren't responding. The VI operates on a closed network. It can't affect any external systems, but we don't have any direct access to its processes. We could bomb it from orbit, but the damage to the facility would be catastrophic. We'd prefer to have someone shut down the core. Someone like you. I know Spectre's answer to the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military. And right now, we need you. The VI controls all the facility's weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
Thank you.
gotta make sure that doesn't happen again.
Looks like Cerberus has other bases on this world, Shepard.
Gotta make sure that doesn't happen.
Cerberus horrors we'll find at the next base.
Thank you.
Won't get me next time.
Thank you.
ready.
Transmission coming in, Commander. I think you're gonna want to hear this one.
Greetings, Commander Shepard. I represent a party interested in obtaining information on Cerberus activities.
Who are you and who do you represent?
Who I am is inconsequential. Suffice to say, I am an agent for the Shadow Broker. You see, Admiral Kohoku contacted my employer looking for information on the location of any Cerberus facilities. We provided that information on the promise that he would turn over copies of all files gathered from the Cerberus systems to us.
Did you have anything to do with Admiral Kohoku ending up dead?
We had no reason to harm him. He was going to provide us with information about Cerberus. Information that is now in your possession.
You must have some connection to Cerberus. How else could you tell Kohoku where to find them?
Information is our business, Commander. Through our contacts, we were able to determine that the Cerberus group was active in the Voyager cluster. Unfortunately, that was all we were able to find out. That is why we are so interested in acquiring copies of the files from you.
These are classified Alliance files. I'm not handing them over to you.
Be reasonable, Commander. Cerberus was operating outside Alliance jurisdiction. You don't owe them any loyalty. The Alliance is just going to file this information away in some archive. No secret stays hidden forever. Eventually, someone somewhere will deliver it into our hands. Might as well be you. Transmit the files to us and you will be well compensated.
What are you going to do with this information?
Information is a commodity. It can be bought, sold, or traded. Why my employer desires this information is not my concern. I am only the buyer.
My loyalty is to the Alliance, not the Shadow Broker.
That is unfortunate, Commander. My employer will remember this the next time you need something from us.
Thank you.
else. Thank you.
Thank you.
Looks like this vessel was abandoned.
Most of the systems seem to be disabled. Only basic life support appears to be functioning. What was that? Is there someone else on this ship?
Somebody set that trap. The whole place could be wired.
Jacob's gone. They say his brain isn't functioning anymore, and they want to shut off his machines. But Jacob's the only thing in the world that matters to me. I don't know how to help him, and it's tearing me up inside. I just feel so helpless, so damn angry. Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't!
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity. It's what he would want. I'm more worried about Julia now. She's showing signs of severe depression. I gave her some meds that should help, but I better warn the captain.
Looks like that machine is keeping him alive.
I do not see any brain activity on the readouts. He is dead. This body is just an empty shell.
Maybe we should shut the machine down. It's the merciful thing to do.
It is your decision, Shepard. But perhaps we should wait until we have more information before we do anything.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to...
Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
That was the compassionate thing to do, Shepard.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Commander, we've got a situation that requires your expertise. A group of fanatical biotics have kidnapped the chairman of the Parliament Subcommittee on Transhuman Studies. They're afraid of sustained damage and is dead in space. Get in there and take them down.
What kind of resistance should I expect?
The biotics were seen loading equipment into the freighter. Expect traps and combat drones. Nothing you can't handle.
What are the biotics asking for?
They're L2 biotics, and most of them are suffering major side effects from the implants. The subcommittee denied a request for reparations to all L2 biotics. Apparently, they'd like the chairman to reconsider.
What's the priority on saving the chairman?
Saving him would be my preference, but we must make it clear that these tactics don't work, Commander. Your top priority is to neutralize the biotics.
Understood, Admiral. I'll see what I can do.
I appreciate you taking the time, Commander. I'm sending you the last known coordinates of the freighter. Good luck. Fifth Fleet out.
See how it is? You write letters and everyone ignores you. Force is the only thing people appreciate. So how about if I kill Chairman Burns and finish this charade?
Please, I was trying to help you people.
Let's not do anything we're all going to regret.
Why not? What have we got to lose? Since the chairman here decided that we didn't get reparations, we've got nothing left to live for.
But I've changed my mind. Seeing you all, it's clear that you all deserve...
You had your chance. Some L2s are nearly crippled from side effects of the implants, but you voted against reparations.
Think about this. Burns is the one man who can help you.
Yes, if you release me, I can take another look at the reparations request.
What, we're supposed to trust you? Sure, you promise us freedom and say everything will be fine, but as soon as we surrender, you'll double-cross us.
I'm not promising to let you go. All I'm saying is that Burns will take another look. Right, Burns?
Absolutely. I had no idea that the L2 biotics were this desperate. If I'd known, the reparations will come. For whatever it's worth, I promise that.
You're right. I don't want to die. Maybe something will happen this time. We surrender.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me. I'll see to it that the reparations discussion is reopened. I didn't know they were so desperate.
A Fifth Fleet cruiser will be by shortly to pick you and the prisoners up.
Thank you.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Thank you for dealing with the hostage situation, Commander. Chairman Burns was quite impressed by the way you resolved the situation peacefully. Your assistance above and beyond the formal duties has been noted, Commander. Fifth Fleet out.
Thank you.
This place looks abandoned.
According to these data logs, the survey team unearthed some kind of alien technology.
Perhaps we will find more answers at the excavation site.
Technology that turned them into mindless fanatics.
Whatever they found, it is long gone now.
Thank you.
equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
Admiral Kahoku, a respected member of the Alliance military, has passed away. The veteran soldier who won the love of his troops during conflict with the Batarians died of natural causes. Kahoku is survived by his wife and three children, who are planning a small private memorial service.
I know you. You're Commander Shepard, the Human Spectre. Is there something I can do for you?
You're Nasana, right? I ran into your sister, Dahlia. It didn't end well for her.
What? Are you saying she's...
Dahlia's dead, Nasana, and I know she was blackmailing you.
And I was all set to try to manipulate you into hunting her down for me. But I guess that won't be necessary now, will it?
You wanted your sister dead?
If people found out my sister was a criminal, I'd be considered a security risk. They'd revoke my clearance, or place me on administrative leave until she was apprehended. I shall transfer a little something into your account as a token of my appreciation. I'm sure you'll find the amount satisfactory.
You're a diplomat on her way up the ranks. It could be handy to have a Spectre who owes you a favor.
You make a good point. Anyone can come up with credits. But I can give you authorization to purchase prototype Asari mods. I will get you added to our manufacturer's preferred client list. I think you'd be very interested in what they have available. Goodbye, Shepard. It has been a pleasure doing business with you.
only darkness, the Enkindlers gave light. Where there was only ignorance.
Reporter Kalisa Al-Jilani recently attempted to land an interview with Commander Shepard, the first human Spectre. Commander Shepard answered difficult questions, demonstrating that under that military uniform is a keen diplomatic mind. We'll have exclusive footage later today.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved. Thank you.